talking about a lot. It's like, it hasn't come up a lot lately, but the whole Christian coalition movement in this country and the things that they support and the things that they do, in my mind, and maybe it's a conspiracy theory, I don't know, but they seem to want to bring about Armageddon in the end times. You know, they're all looking for this. And then, I mean, like, to me, this is what's going on over there in the Middle East a lot, is everybody thinks the end times are coming. And, you know, like when Ariel Sharon visited the Temple Mount a while ago, I guess that might have been 7-8 years ago now, that was a very provocative thing at the time, because the Jews retaking the Temple Mount was one of the prophecies of, you know, a sign of the end times coming. And then after that, I found out that the Christian Coalition actually funds this ranch down in Texas where they're actually trying to breed a cow that has red fur, because supposedly the Jews are going to sacrifice a blood red bull on the Temple Mount, you know? And to me, it's just bizarre that, like, you know, these people that are in power, some of them, not all of them, are really pushing things from a religious perspective that I don't think generally people are aware of, you know? And it's just kind of a scary thing to me, I guess. You know, for one, we live in a country that's rapidly becoming, well, in a way, I don't know, actually. I mean, I felt like it's becoming more secular in a lot of ways, but also there's people that are going, you know, harder. The extremes are, like, really getting defined now, more and more people are going way one way or way the other. And, you know, I think in a situation like that where there's organizations that are actively seeking to bring about, like, the prophecies in the Bible of the end times, they probably don't really want people knowing that, you know? I mean, some people wouldn't believe it. They're just going to chalk it up to a conspiracy theory. And maybe it is. Maybe I don't know what I'm talking about here. But, you know, I don't think that they want that known, you know, and because people would rise up against those types of ideas, you know. I mean, who wants to end the world, you know? I mean, really. But, you know, and George Bush was, you know, part of the go-between, I guess, for this ranch that, you know, it's somebody of his that owned the land. And, you know, it's just bizarre to me that they're actually taking those steps, you know.
You know, the fact that this was the warmest winter on record in a lot of places by far, I mean, maybe I don't pay attention to the news that much, and so I haven't noticed it being reported, but I you know, maybe I'm missing it, but I haven't really, like, I turn on NPR and I get the 5-minute update at the beginning of the hour and whatever, and I, you know, and I just get the kind of the highlights of what's going on, and I never really hear it mentioned in a way that is bringing it to, I feel like, the attention that it needs. I mean, I feel like we're at a catastrophic point, like, especially after this winter and where we're going from here, and you know, Obama is about to approve the southern route of the Keystone Pipeline, and which he said that he wouldn't do, and, you know, I feel like that there's no way that could happen if people really knew what was going on and you know, and knew how it was going to affect their lives in the long term. So the fact that people don't know, and, you know, are the fact that people are okay with being ignorant to the consequences of the trajectory that we're on makes me feel like it's either not getting reported enough or it's not getting the right kind of attention. So, but I know it's a really complicated thing because it affects, you know, the livelihood of a lot of people and, you know, the billionaire corporations that basically run the White House and the rest of government. So.